This is the Central Business Architecture Committee meeting on Tuesday, July 17th, 2018. We will be reviewing an addition at 60C Masonic Street, Northampton map ID 31D-258. Before we get started, is there anyone here that has any public comment on anything other than what's on the agenda? Nope. Then we will ask the applicant to come forward and make a presentation.
I'm Tom Douglas. I'm an architect in Northampton, and Seth Jolly in the blue shirt is the owner. So, I had a thumb drive presentation with photographs and everything, but no computer, so I have to just hold up with the dumb boards.
Okay.
So this is just the enlarged site plan. So I don't know if you guys know where it is, but it's behind the old fire station where Windstar is. And this is the house you can see, and I think that is existing there now. And then we're going to add on an elevator to the side, which will go all the way up to the third floor. And so the site layout currently is some parking, three parking spaces underneath the big overhang. The house projects out to here. There's parking spaces there. Then there's a little green space right there. And this represents a stone wall that's there now that we're going to retain. So we're just carving out a little bit of land on the side to put this elevator in. And then we're going to add an addition to the third floor. So this house was built in 2011. And then Seth also built the house next to it and lived in it for a while too. So he's had a long, and he's a director of Media Education Foundation that basically renovated the fire station for that. So these are all three floor plans, first, second, and third. So on the first floor, you can see in blue that we're adding that elevator. Second floor, you can see, because it's a little bigger down there because it's got a vestibule, an elevator, and a little machine room attached to it. So it has a bigger footprint on, you know, on the ground than it does on the upper level. So here it is on the second floor. You get into the second floor. And then this is the third floor here, so it's come up here. And then we're adding that amount of square footage to the third floor. So the whole house is that big. So what we had originally done was we had a stair up there that access the roof deck, but we had planned for this addition in the future, so we're going to add that amount there, and we'll have a roof deck over here. And remember, there's a house right next door to it that, so you barely even will see this roof deck, so it's kind of very hemmed in. So this is a front elevation. So this is the neighboring house that we designed, I can't remember what year, and then this is the proposed house here. So we're adding what exists is that much right there now. And then what we're adding is this upper floor right here. So you can see the elevator comes up, accesses this upper floor there. So I just have this as a comparison of height. And this is very symmetrical. This is very asymmetrical. This was stucco and shingles. This is all stucco now. So this is old fashioned stucco. This is new polymer stucco. So it's a super insulated house, the new one. We used a wall system that has foam on the outside and then the polymer stucco on the inside. So that elevation I just showed you, I squished them all. All the elevations are on the same page. So this right here is the front elevation that I just showed you. So like I said, this is all existing here. This is the new addition. And when you look at it from the side, from the north side, so if you're at Sirio's looking at it, or State Street, this bit here was existing, that bit was existing. But, so here's the elevator that goes up, and then that's the addition we're adding to the third floor. So you can see in section, the roof is a continuation of the roof existing now, and then it pops up out at the front. And that you're seeing the little pop-up in the front there. And then the other side that faces Seth's old house's roof, and then the little pop-up, and then their not sliding doors, but those pivoting bifold doors. And we'll match the same, all the materials are gonna be the same as what's existing there. Doors and windows and stucco will all be the same. We'll probably, for the new addition up there, we'll probably use a color that is slightly different than what's there already, because we'd never be able to match it exactly, so we can pick out a slightly different color that's subtle, doesn't jump out at home. That's it.
The whole third floor would be a different color?
So this is there.
Yeah.
So this bit right there, we would choose. So what we already did was this, we'll probably pick this color. So this little bump right here, juts out, is a slightly lighter color than the body of the house behind it. So we can probably take that and put it on this.
So the wall around the roof garden is going to be in that material? Is that going to be like glass or some sort of railing?
Well, yeah, this wall right here is existing.
Okay, so, but I mean like around the side, like you're creating a roof garden that's not there right now, right?
Well, there is,
there is.
Yeah, so there is a...
So the roof garden exists currently?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, so we're taking away a roof garden.
Okay,
and,
I see what you're saying.
And
end up
with less roof garden.
Okay.
So I didn't bring an existing one, but you know, right now, I'm sorry I don't have the pictures to look at, but right now, when you look at the side, you see the two-story house, and then this tower kind of element jutting up, and then the roof extending out to up here. So we're just going to close and add to that.
And the elevator addition is going to match whatever color it's adjacent to, is that the idea?
Yeah, this elevator addition. Yeah, and all the trims and the fascias and stuff will match what we've already got, so. Windows, same tall casement windows with lintels that we have used before.
Interested in
the timing. Thank you.
Okay. All right.
back myself. So I should, when you're free the next couple of days.
What do you say?
How's he doing?
He's good. He sent a message this week.
Okay, great, thanks.
Maybe last week.
Thanks.
And he sounded very cheery, and he said he was, you know, on the road to recovery, wasn't quite ready to come to meetings, but he was,
How long has he been retired?
Can I get a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
All in favor?
Aye.